were some of the frugal tips and tricks that you use that you remember that actually, some of them do you still abide by? And also, you mentioned
Yeah.
some of the interesting ones where you like sitting in your jacket to say, see how long you go without your heater. Do you have any more, again, of both of ones you still might follow and ones that you're still like, that you remember being like some of the more extreme examples?
Yeah, I think so my entire financial philosophy, like while I was working at Google, really was based on like a bunch of those frugality blogs I was reading, which I'll get into some of those things in a bit. And then that book, A Random Walk Down Wall Street, like I said that as a joke, but it's totally not a joke. I do have that book on my coffee table. Great book. If you take anything from this, go read that book, because it literally like it they just sum it up so well why like why you should diversify. Like they took what I was expecting to be an extremely complicated subject, which is investing, and I think a lot of people kind of feel that way, like it's this mysterious way to just make money out of nothing. They took this subject of investing and simplified it down to something that's actually really, really digestible and understandable and like surprisingly easy to do. And like the author actually sits on the board of Wealthfront, which is where I have put most of my money, because basically Wealthfront, I'm going to plug Wealthfront right now. I'm going to send out my
Yeah, please
referral link
do.
to everybody watch
Yeah, it's in the comments.
it.
I beat you.
Yeah. So yeah, Wealthfront is just an automated, they automate all of the like smart financial things you should do with your money, so you don't have to think about it and do it yourself. So while I was at Google, I was just shoveling money into there. And then yeah, in terms of frugality, it was really about just building a habit of being mindful of your spending and like understanding where the money's going, what are your biggest cost factors, and getting in kind of a routine of like reevaluating your financial situation, making sure like I shop for insurance probably like once or twice a year, like car
Really?
insurance, because I find that sometimes I'm just way overpaying. Like that whole Geico thing is true. Save
15 minutes or what?
50% or more or 15 minutes or less, whatever it is. Like I have been in that situation before, and like there are so many weird arbitrary things that certain insurance companies charge you extra for. Like when I moved to San Francisco, like the same it was like the same summer that I moved to San Francisco, I also got a speeding ticket going like 85 plus and a 55 or something, and my insurance literally doubled with in my next like pay period. I was like, what the heck is going on? And I ended up shopping around, and I found that even with that ticket, even living in San Francisco where like people's windshields get smashed all the time, I was able to get cheaper car insurance just by shopping around. And I had just kind of like been lazy and not thought about it for a while. And so now like I go check, get quotes every so often, and almost always I knock like $100 off my 6 month premium.
Wow,
And
nice.
yeah, so there's that. There's yeah, just the whole mindfulness thing. Like I remember that whole Mr. Money Mustache blog. I don't know if you've heard of this guy, but he's all about retiring early. And yeah, he kind of like really drills the point of like understanding that a lot of the things we do day to day and take for granted are expenses, right? Like every time you get in your car and take a trip somewhere, that's an expense. So I started biking to work. I started biking to the store sometimes, started walking places. Yeah, it's just about like, yeah, being mindful of all those little things you do day to day. Every time you flip on your heater, that's an expense. Every time you obviously go out to eat, that's a huge expense. And as long as you kind of are mindful each time you're spending money on these things, you can kind of create a habit of like I said, almost making it painful to spend the money. I don't like putting it that way because a big criticism I've seen of frugal lifestyle is like you got to live a little, you know? spend money, you know, that can make you happy, like spend money on a nice dinner or whatever. Right. And that's true. I totally agree. But what I found in living a frugal lifestyle is there are a lot of things you can do to cut back on expenses and not sacrifice lifestyle at all. And sometimes it can even be fun, like a fun and interesting challenge to see how low you can get your expenses to go. And then the earlier you do that in your life, the more money you save, like that compounds over time. And it just creates this huge self-fulfilling snowball effect. And that's where I say I'm a Buffett disciple. I listened to Warren Buffett's entire director's cut unabridged biography on Audible. It's like 42 hours. You know every single thing that man has ever done. And he's all about that. It was the book's called The Snowball because it's about compound growth and just making smart decisions with your money, being rational, being reasonable over a very long period of time. Like you're guaranteed to win pretty much.
Yeah. In order to also see how much you're spending and being frugal, have you used any apps to track that as well?